Hello and welcome to the News Hour. How are all you folks this evening? Right, absolutely spiffing. Now, in the latest news, the snail swimming event has been cancelled, to be replaced by the scene of cinder blocks lying on the ground. In other news, the Prime Minister's left shoe was viciously gunned down yesterday in a shooting outside a small tea shop near Bristol. We go now to the Prime Minister's secretary, who earlier this evening gave a statement concerning the shooting.
Earlier this day, the Prime Minister was indeed assaulted by two men who rushed in and grabbed his left shoe. They then proceeded to shoot the shoe several times before making their getaway in a black van parked around the corner. Officials were unable to identify the van, however, investigations are proceeding. The Prime Minister is unable to comment himself at this time. However, he wishes to deny any rumours that he was involved with the Russian mob and owes them considerable amounts of money, or that he was the alleged criminal mastermind behind the bombing outside Leeds several years back, or that he holds wild parties on government time, or that he was involved in shady dealings with would-be terrorists, or that he sold his youngest daughter to a young couple 3 months ago that he met at the wedding of a friend, in exchange for his very own lakeside manor, or that this violent attack had anything to do with any of them.
Splendid. And may we all keep the Prime Minister in our thoughts as he copes with this shocking turn of events. And now, we turn to Dr. Ted for our cat healthcare fact of the day.
Oh, thanks, Chip. Now, today's cat healthcare fact is about proper cat hygiene, a.k.a. baths. Now, does giving your cat a bath cause stress? Well, now, the answer really is quite simple. Yes, your typical cat does not like water and so gets stressed out when presented with the threat of water. Now, also on rare occasions, giving your cat a bath can result in a breakout of bleeding cuts and scratches, rarely resulting in death. Allow me to demonstrate. You take your cat like this, and you take your sponge. You dip the cat in the bucket and scrub-a-dub-dub, cat. Scrub-a-dub-dub. Scrub-a-dub-dub. Well, that's the cat healthcare fact of the day. Cats don't like baths. It's best off to leave them to their own devices. Well, folks, that's all for today. Until next time, ta-ta.
And now we go live to Liverpool for coverage on the Millipede Racing Championship.
Welcome, one and all, to the Millipede Racing Championship. Today, you will witness the greatest millipede race to ever take place on the north side of the channel. We have here today one of the greatest millipede racers, Billy Hagman and his millipede Flash. Together, they have won over 50 gold medals and even made it to the World Championships in Paris, France, in the spring of 09, taking home the silver medal. Competing against them today is a relative newcomer to the sport, Sea Jumper, out of North Ireland, and his owner, Seamus McTilligotty. They have quickly made their way up through the ranks and are here today to attempt to steal the gold trophy out from under Flash's antenna. And now their owners lead them onto the field. It appears that McTilligotty is having some trouble with Sea Jumper. Bad luck that, and the race not even started yet. Oh, and here he comes. Both Flash and Sea Jumper appear to be a bit nervous, of course. This is a big day for them. One hoping to rise to the top, one trying desperately to maintain a firm grasp upon a well-deserved title. And McTilligotty and Hagman now take lead off to the sidelines as the race is about to begin.
On your mark, get set.
And it begins, and it looks like they're off to a slow start, but what's this? Sea Jumper has taken the lead. Still no sign of movement from Flash, and Sea Jumper is coming up to the first marker. But wait, here comes Flash, moving along quickly now. He's coming up fast on Sea Jumper, who is looking a bit nervous now as he approaches the second marker. And he... No! The noise from the crowd is too much for young Sea Jumper, and Flash passes him, heading for the third marker. Come on, Sea Jumper! He looks very lost down there, but yes, there he goes, back on track. Will he ever be able to catch up to Flash? It is not looking likely right now, but other things have happened. And Flash passes the third marker with Sea Jumper coming up behind him. It's going to take a miracle for him to win now, as they both hurtle along. Flash is slowing down, and can Sea Jumper take the lead? And no! Flash puts on a burst of speed and passes the finishing line, leading Sea Jumper to take home second. And the crowd goes wild as Flash takes home yet another gold medal. There's just no stopping that millipede.
Ah well, happy ending all in all. And now it's time for The Word on the Street. The word on the street today is vigilante. And to talk about what vigilante means, we have Don Filippo.
Well, you see, so a vigilante is actually, it comes from the Spanish word vigilant, meaning to be watchful, to be alert, see? And a vigilante is a, it's kind of someone who takes the law into his own hands when the proper authorities ain't doing nothing, see? Now, if you'll excuse me a minute, I got some business. Now, you see, that were an act of vigilantizing, though actually, me and my boys, we ain't really vigilantes, see? You see, we loan out the money to the guys, right? And when they don't pay up, we make them an offer they can refuse, see? So, you see, it ain't really taking the law into your own hands, see? Because it ain't really lawful, per se, see?
Well, that's the word on the street. And now we've reached the end of our broadcast, but come back tomorrow for the latest news around the country. Bye-bye.
Yeah.